When I was about 8 or 9 years old, I was diagnosed with a retropharyngeal abscess, and I had to be admitted into the hospital to have it drained. And I can tell you that was absolutely terrifying. And so what happened was, is despite the fact that it was an incredibly traumatizing experience, I was absolutely fascinated with the world of medicine. I think that experience is what helped me decide to go into medicine. Once I decided that that was going to be my career goal, I started just working really hard. I think the school that you go to, the amount of dedication you put into that, the grades, I tried to get as involved as I could in working in a hospital. I was a candy striper, and I actually did some shadowing with some doctors, and it was a great experience. So that really just opened my eyes to medicine and really got me interested. Well, my dad was a professor at Michigan State University, and so it was pretty understood that that's probably where I would end up going. So I ended up there for my undergraduate experience. And then I applied and was got into the University of Michigan for my medical school training. And I was going to be a pediatric cardiologist, but fortunately I stumbled into an elective in radiology very early in my medical school training and just fell in love with it. I really enjoyed the challenge of interpreting an image. I enjoyed working with doctors and all the disciplines of medicine and interacting with them. So that was a natural choice for me. As I was going through the process of trying to decide what specialty I was interested in, I ended up in women's imaging. And I chose women's imaging for many reasons. First of all, I really enjoyed working with women. I enjoyed interpreting mammograms, but I also enjoyed the fact that there was going to be involvement with patients. I could do breast ultrasound, I could do ultrasound guided biopsies, I could do stereotactic biopsies and have some hands-on contact with patients, which I absolutely love. The next stop was an amazing job opportunity here in Las Vegas, and I joined Steinberg Diagnostic Medical Imaging in the year 2000. So they have always been very cutting edge, and we're always looking for new technology and always being at the brink of whatever's coming out. And the other thing is I'm very passionate about mammography, but I'm also very passionate about educating our community, especially the women of Las Vegas, about mammography. The best thing to do is to educate your patient. I think the more that they know about what's going on in the world of mammography, first of all, the more compliant they're going to be, and the more likely they are to going to come in and get their mammogram. I think that they know the facts. 80% of breast cancer happens spontaneously. No family history and no risk factors. It's completely out of the blue, and that's what makes mammography so important. I think the healthcare industry in this town is absolutely phenomenal. I think you really have to really believe in your physician, and if you have a good physician-patient relationship, then I think the sky's the limit.
Bashar always stays even keel, which is amazing. She can stay like that all day, and she gets so many interruptions because she's called on a lot. You know, whether it's me calling on things, other chiefs needing her for different things, she's always there, she's always accessible. And then you can really trust her when she speaks to you. She's straight to it, straight to the point. She always insists on, she'll say it to me, "Robin, we have to give them our best. We have to give them our best work. You know, they want the best of us." And so she raises the bar, and we all try to reach it with her. And it's because of her, I think, that we are doing so well in our mammography program. SDMI is really lucky to have her. I respect and love you so much, and it's a pleasure working with you every day.
As a radiologist, there's a few attributes that really make you outstanding. And one of them is being able to make a decision and feel confident in it. And Dr. Shaw has really an amazing ability to make a decision, to follow up, and to feel confident in her decision. And that really has instilled a lot of confidence in the referring doctors and in the patients as far as her recommendations. You know, she's a great radiologist. She's a beautiful person. She's a wonderful mother, a great wife, a great member of our group. I'm thrilled for her to be a part of SDMI. I think we're all fortunate that she's in our community.
Hi, Ann. Congratulations on this tremendous award. There isn't a day that goes by that I'm amazed by your commitment to your craft and the community and how every day you make yourself a better person and a better doctor. You're amazing with our kids, the best mom they could have, and there's no better wife that I could ever ask for.
Congratulations on this award. We are all so proud of you and everything you've done for this community. I just wanted to let you know you've always been one of my biggest inspirations, and it inspires me and motivates me every day to know that my mom is doing such great things in this community. So congratulations, you deserve this.
Hi Mom, congratulations. As you know, I couldn't be there tonight, but I wanted to tell you that I'm so proud of you. You're an amazing mom and an outstanding doctor. You deserve this recognition 100%. I love you so much, and I can't wait to come home and give you a big hug.